Ancient Greek sculptures were brightly colored, so why do we still see them as white? It started back in the Renaissance. After many of these sculptures had been underground for hundreds of years, they had lost a lot of their pigment. The classical revivalists like Michelangelo really leaned into the idea that they were pure white, and the idea of race was being invented around that time, and white was starting to become the ideal. But things really got cooking in the 1700s with this guy, Johann Joachim Winckelmann. He wrote a couple major books on ancient sculpture and art history and was seen by many as both the father of modern archaeology and art history itself. He actively ignored and suppressed any evidence of pigment on these ancient sculptures. He viewed white marble sculpture as the embodiment of beauty. Referring to white marble, he literally said, "The whiter the body is, the more beautiful it is." He was also a self-proclaimed Eurocentrist and regularly wrote really racist things about people of other nationalities and ethnicities. In the history of white people, Nell Irvine Painter wrote that color in sculpture came to mean barbarism, for they assumed that the lofty ancient Greeks were too sophisticated to color their art. Over time, a lot of these pigments were literally cleaned away. Restoration of stone sculptures in the past used a lot of acids and was much more aggressive than it is today. But these restoration practices also reflected the aesthetics of the time, that whiteness was the embodiment of beauty. But it's not just about the ancient Greeks and Romans being evolved and civilized enough to just use white marble. It also created the myth that they literally were white, which is so not true. You only need to look at the wide variety of sarcophagus paintings and mosaics to see that it was a very multi-ethnic time and place. There was a huge variety of skin tones present. Even this depiction of Alexander the Great is not lily white. But when classicist Sarah Bond suggested this in her groundbreaking article, she was viciously attacked by white supremacists on the internet. The thing is that ethno-nationalists and neo-Nazis often use the myth that civilization was created by white people. And it's not just neo-Nazis, classical studies academia also contributes to this. So while these restorations are important for showing us that these ancient sculptures were actually brightly colored, they often continue to contribute to the idea that ancient Greece was mostly white people by painting these weird neon pink skin tone colors. Here's another restoration. While the skin tones do survive on a lot of ancient paintings and mosaics, the pigments of skin tones on sculptures are often totally faded. Most of the time. Which is why, even here, this pink skin tone is most likely totally fabricated. By the way, this discussion relates to architecture too. The Parthenon used to be brightly colored, and there is much more to talk about there. As always, like and subscribe for more anti-authoritarian folk art history content. I'm also on YouTube and Instagram, and you can support me on Patreon. Stay colorful, everyone!